Hello everyone. So we were left with certain topics which we couldn't cover in our workshop. So I am going to make this small video where I'll be covering those leftover topics. So we were left with the functions. A few functions were left. We had the date and text functions. So I will be starting with the date functions. Now this is a very interesting thing to understand, that in Excel, how Excel stores dates. Excel stores dates as numbers. It stores dates in number forms. So the number one is nothing but 1st January 1900. Okay, so it is 1st January 1900 that is taken to be as number one. So if you type any number and you change that, so let me just show this to you all. This is number one. If I change the format of this to date, then it will change to 1st January 1900. So I will go to the home tab in this numeric section. I will change this to date. And the moment I change this to date, you will see it is 1900. Let me just keep a long date. There are two forms, short date, long date. I can also adjust this. I can also format this. What you can do is simply right click, click on format cells, click on format cells, and then you have different, in the date section itself, you have different formats. Can you see? You have different formats. Suppose I want to select this format. This is month, day, and year format. This is month, day, and year format. Correct? So I can select this format as well. And the moment I click on this, you see it has changed to 1/1/1900. So you can understand that number 1 is taken as 1st January 1900. Similarly, if you type any number and you change that into the date format, you will understand that what number that particular date signifies. Similarly, if I take today's date and I change it into number, or I change it into general format, then you will get the today's number. So I will show you all that as well. So I have made a very interesting exercise over here for you all. So what you have to do, the first step for you all is to write your birthdays over here. So my birthday, I'm writing my birthday 15th September 1997. So this is what I am going to write. This is my birthday. So it has automatically, can you see, it has automatically changed to a format of month, day, and year. Month, day, and year. If you want to change it back, again, what you can do is right click, click on format cells, click on format cells, go to the custom category over here, and from here you can change. See, in the custom itself, you have month and then you have the date. So let me change this down. Let me keep D over here. And let me keep M over here. Basically, in the custom, you can yourself change the formatting of anything you want to. Here in the date section, it is according to what it is here. You can't change, you can't keep it as per your own wish, correct? But here, when you go to the custom section, you can type yourself the way you want it to be. So I want it to be in form of D, which is date first, and then M, which is month first, which is what we follow in India. First the date, then the month, and then the year. This format of month, then the date is followed in America, in US. But we follow the British version. So we follow date, month, and then the year. Okay. So now I'll just simply click on OK. The moment I click on OK, see, it has changed. It has changed. Okay. So let's start. Now, this is the date which has been given to us. Any date can be given to us. You will be writing your own date of birth here. Suppose from any date, I want to take out just the day portion, just the month portion, and just the year portion. Now, why is this? This is a small exercise which I have taken. Generally, what happens is that when we deal with large amounts of dates, suppose order date, when we have a proper data and a business wants to deal with the order date, correct? When was the order placed of the client, and then the business wants to understand when will be the credit fall when will be the credit date, credit due date. Basically, if I have a business and I am giving credit for 14 days. You are my client and I'm giving you credit for 14 days. So you have purchased something from me, maybe on, let's suppose 1st October 2020. Now, there are many customers who are purchasing on certain dates. So I have a record of the entire order date with myself. But I also want to calculate when will be the due date of your credit to be paid to me. Correct? I want to take out that particular due date so that I can call the client and I can ask for my payment. So for that, in those cases, we take out the day. So it was 1st October 2020. So day is first. Day is first, and then I will add 14 to it. I will add 14 to it so that I will understand, okay, 15th October is the time, is the date when I will receive payment from you. So that is a small example which I have discussed. The application is really huge. So I will take the day function to find out the date. It's very simple. It's just a basic English, like how do you find out the day of a date? Day function. Okay, and you just have to select the serial number. So why it is serial number? Because as I said, the dates in Excel are stored in the form of numbers. So basically any serial number you write here, if you write 1, so it is basically 1st January 1900, so you will get a day of 1. Similarly, any number you write, that will get changed into the date first, and then the corresponding day will be derived. So this is 15. Now I want the month. So the function is again month. This is my date, the serial number. You can type any serial number. If you type 2000, you will get the respective month. First 2000 will be changed into the date format, and then it will return you the, suppose here if I type 2000, so see it has changed to 22nd June 1905. Correct. Similarly, if I want the year, I will select this date and I will get the year as 1997. So this is how you get your day, month and year. Okay. Moving on. So my birthday, what I'll do, I'll give a equal. Now, suppose there is a function called date function as well. So we have learnt 3 functions. Day, month, year. We have also seen how we can format different kinds of date. If you want, you can go to the custom and you can get it in your own way. Or even in the date section, we saw that there are different ways in which you can get the date. Now here, suppose you are given with day, you are given with month, you are given with year, and then you have to take out the date of that. You have to change that. Suppose this is given to me. This entire thing is given to me. I want to change this into a date. I use the date function. So in the date function, the first argument is year. So this is my year, correct? This is my year. Go according to the arguments, the way arguments are placed. You cannot first take day over here because Excel is asking you to give a year. Even if you mention 15 over here, 15 will be taken as the year by Excel. Okay. So comma, month. Month is nothing but this 9, which we see, and day. So you have to go in this format, which is year, month and day. You can't go according to your own format because these are the specified arguments which Excel wants you to enter. Now see, again I get 15th September 1907. Again, I can format this. I can click right click, format cells. In the date section itself, I can select any of the format over here. Let me just keep it this way itself because this is what suits me. If you want to change this, you can simply go to the long date version also if you want. Or you can go to the format cells option over here, right click format cells, and you can select any option which is given over here in the date section. If you want it to be according to yourself, then go to the custom section and select from here. You can select any of these you want to. See, there are multiple options. You can also type your own thing over here. Correct? So let me keep it this way. If I want, I can just keep YY so that I get the entire. And see, this is the sample, 15th September 1997. So let me just keep it this way itself. Now, what is today's date? we use a function called today. We use a function called today. We use a function called today function to find out today's date. So I type today. I type today. You do not have to specify any argument. See, there are no arguments which you need to specify. Simply close the bracket and you will get today's date, which is 15th October 2020. Let me do one thing. Let me format Painter and change, because there is no point in changing the format again and again. What you could have also done is that you could have selected the entire thing and then did the right click, format cells, and then change the formatting. That can also be done. You can change the format of more than one cell also. What I did was I selected the format painter option, which is nothing but to copy paste the formatting of that particular cell. So this is today's date. I found out using today function. Now I want to calculate the days until my birthday. So I was born on 15th September 1997. Today is 15th October 2020. So what are the number of days since I was born till today? How do I do that? That's a simple calculation. I do today minus my birthday. Correct? So basically the thing which I wanted to show you all is that you can add, subtract different dates. Okay? I don't think you can't divide. There is no point in dividing and multiplying two dates. But yes, there is a point where you can divide, you can subtract, and you can add two different dates. Again, you can take any business application over here. Suppose there are two dates given to us. One is the purchase date and one is the payment date. I want to analyze that what is the duration between the two. So I can simply do payment date minus the purchase date. So I can understand, okay, what is my behavior? How is my payment? How fast my payments are being made? So that is how you can also understand. So now here we have 8431 days. So you can understand that from 15th September 1997 till today, I have lived for 8,431 days. So you can calculate your own days like this. Okay, it's very simple. Now here again, what is today's day, month, and year? Again, this uses day, month, and year function. This I'm leaving for you all to do. Again, I'll just show you all the day. Again, it's very simple day, and you have to select the today's date, and you'll get it as 15th. So today I'm making the video on 15th October. For you, if you're seeing the video some other day, then you are practicing it in some other day, so you'll get that particular day's date. If I type, so I wanted to show you all this as well. If I type any number, let me just type. So if I type this number, let me type this number, 8431. 8431. Let me see what date it is. So see, it gives me 30th. It gives me 30th January some date, maybe 2000. Okay, so this is how it works. You can give any number, but generally we use it with dates itself. Just the way to show that in Excel, the dates are stored in numeric format, where day one, when number one is nothing but 1st January 1900. That means Excel started recording dates from 1st January 1900. You cannot record any date which is before this particular day. Okay. Moving on, if I want, so this was today function using which I got today's date. If I want date and time together, I will use now function. This will give me this moment's date and time together. See, I have to increase the size a bit, and I get it as 15th October 2020. You can again change the format of this. So I'll just simply right click, click on format cells, and this is how you get it. Suppose you want it in format of, you just want the time format. So see, I'm just getting the time, which is 11:21:32 a.m. where 32 is the seconds. So it entirely depends upon how you want it to look like. Okay, so this is how, if you can just simply add seconds over here, you will also get seconds. If you want to add AM PM, you will also get AM PM. See, just because it's AM, you got a AM. If it was at night, you would have got PM. Okay, so this is how I can change according to my ease, but do not randomly write anything. If you are giving a currency symbol to a date, that does not mean anything. Correct? So logically put any formatting options which you want to. So see, I have over here 15th October 2020. Just the 20 is there. If you want, you can give Y four times. If you give Y four times, you will get the entire year. And then I have the time itself. Okay. Again and again, if you change this, this will change. See, if I just double click, the time changed to 11:23. Double click, time changed to 23:08 seconds. So this is how, see, it changed to 13 seconds. So this is how the now function. If I open my Excel file tomorrow, and if I'll be sending you all this Excel file, and if you all be opening this tomorrow, the date over here will change. The time and the date over here will change because Excel performs all these functions again and again. The moment you perform any one function in Excel, what Excel does is that it performs all other functions which are there in your workbook, not only in this sheet but the entire workbook again. So even if I make a small calculation, let's suppose 9 plus 9, let us suppose 9 plus 9, then see, this is changing. Obviously, date will not change, but the time will change. But if you want a static date and a static time, meaning you do not want to change the date and you do not want to change the time, then you use the shortcut which I showed you all in my section 3, which is Control Shift, and a semicolon, and Control Semicolon for date, Control Shift Semicolon for time. This will not change your date and time. This will keep it as it is of that particular time. Let me show you all this as well. Control. So this is my static time. Control shift semicolon. This is my time. Now let me just see whether this is changing or not. Let me change this to seconds also so that I'm able to understand properly. So see, this is 11:24. Now let me perform any other calculation. This is not changing. See, this is changing. This cell is changing, but this cell is not changing. You get a static date, time, which does not change. Similarly, control, semicolon will give you date, which will not change. So these two are static ones, which will not change. Control, semicolon, control, shift, semicolon. Moving on to the text function. Okay, another very important and interesting function to deal with. I have written my name over here, Shivangi Agarwal. You can write your own name and you can try the entire exercise. Now I want, this is already in uppercase. Let me do one thing. Change the case of this. Just randomly I'm writing Shivangi and then Agarwal. Okay. Now I want all the things to be in uppercase or maybe in capital letters. So I use the function upper. Very simple. I use the function upper. And I get everything in my uppercase. See, everything is there in the uppercase. Everything is there in the uppercase. Okay. I want to change everything to the lowercase. Function is lower. Function is lower. See, everything got changed to Shivangi Agarwal in smalls. Small letter. I want to change it in a sentence case. Now, what is a sentence case? Sentence cases, basically all your words first letters will be in caps lock. So see what happens if I select this cell. See, S is in capital, A is in capital, rest everything is in small. So what is a sentence case? Basically this is not a sentence case exactly, but something which makes all the first letters of every word capital. So it will change the first letter of all the words to capital and the rest of the letters will be small. So this is what happened. The entire caps lock, the entire capital letters of Agarwal has changed to small, just leaving A as capital and here S as capital. So the first letters of your word will be capitalized, okay? Not a sentence case exactly, but yeah, you can say this as changing the first letters of all the words to capital. Okay, so this was your basic upper, lower and proper functions. Now moving on to some important functions over here. Now what are these important functions which I have? Suppose I have taken the entire list of customer IDs over here. This consists of, I will give you a small idea about this, what it consists of. It consists of, the first is the category, CG is the category, CG, DV, SO, BH. These are the different categories of my customer. Maybe small, maybe you can say customers in different industrial, different industries or different companies can be considered as a categorical thing over here. I've taken this data from internet. So CG, DV, SO, BH, these are nothing but different categories of customers which I deal with. L, S, M, these are nothing but the size of the customers, whether the customer is large, medium or small, depending on the quantity the customer is purchasing from me. And rest of the four, five digits which you see over here is the nothing but the customer number which I have given. Maybe there are two customers, as you can see over here, who can have same category, who can have same type, large, medium and small, but the number should change, right? Number cannot be same, number will be as per the customer. So this is my customer ID which is given to me. I will use these functions in order to understand this. Now, very first is, if I want to take out the length of the entire customer ID, or you can say any string which is there with me, basically these are the strings which I have written. 12520 is also a string in this case. Why? Because I have written this, used this with these letters. I have used this with these letters. Okay? So, length, I will use the len function. Len, okay, len function, I will use this text and I get a length of 10. All will have a length of 10 over here in this case, but this is not always the case when you are using it for name, when you are using for address, when you are using it for cities, then obviously you get different letters. Here, I will have all as 10 because we have two letters first for the category. Then one letter for the type, large, small, medium, and five letters for the number. Okay. I want to now extract just the category of this customer ID. I want to extract just the category of this customer ID. How do I do this? Using the left function. So basically, I know that all my customer ID code is written in a particular format. First the category, then the type, and then the number. I know this. Okay, I know this. Now I just want to deal with different categories. I want to analyze that what are the different categories of customers which give me highest sales. So I just want to deal with the category section. So I need to extract the categories from these. How do I do this? I use the left function. I want to extract something from the left side. From the left side. So I use the left function. The text which I want to extract things from, I want to extract it from this particular text. Number of characters. Now see that this argument is within the brackets. When you have these arguments within the brackets, this means that these arguments are not compulsory. If I just leave it like this and see what happens, it just gives me C, which means by default, the number of letters which has been extracted is just 1. By default, the number of characters which has been extracted is just 1. So I'm just getting C. But I want 2. First, 2 characters, which is CG or maybe DV, S0, BH. So I want first two. So I will give 2 as my second argument. And see, I get CG as the CG, BH, SO. These are the different categories which I deal with. Then I want to extract the number of my customer. So now I want to also analyze the different customer IDs. I want the serial numbers, the unique serial number of all my customers. As you can see, the serial number will always remain unique to all the customer. So I want to extract that. That is towards the right side. So from the left, when we extracted, we used the left function. From the right, when I want to extract, it will be obviously right function. So these functions are very simple. You just need to understand where to apply, how to apply. Okay. So I select this text. Number of characters which I want is always 5. Now this is only the case when the number of characters remains same. If you have two people with two different letters, two different length of letters, then these things are not possible. But here, when you have general way of presentation and you know that the last 5 characters are your number, customer number, so I can simply write a 5 over here and get the last 5 digits. And by default, if you can see that this is placed towards the left because this is taken to be as a text string. Here it is middle line because maybe I have kept it like that. But it's up to you. How can you change the alignment? That was the number. Now suppose if we want to take out large, small and medium, the middle thing, how can you use left? Because if you are using something as left, it will take up this text. And suppose I give first three characters. So it will give me, see, what it will give me? It will give me CG dash. If I use right and right function and I maybe write, I want 6 letters. So it give me, it will give me a dash 12520. Right. So this is not what we want. Actually, we want something from the middle of the text, from the middle of this string. This is known as string, the middle of the string. So I use a function called mid function. Now this mid function is a little complicated, but I will explain you in a very simple way. The very first thing again is the text from which you want to extract the things from. So this is your text from which you want to extract your text from. This is your string from which you want to extract. What is the starting number from where you want to start extracting? Now here in case of left, it was the very first letter. In case of right, it was the very last letter from which it started extracting. So you just had to mention the number of characters which you wanted to extract. See, in case of left, the place from which it started to extract was 1. In case of right, the place from which it started to extract was the very end, the very last. So you just mentioned the number of characters which you want, which you wanted to extract. In case of left, you wanted to extract 2 letters. In case of right, you wanted to extract 5 letters. So you just mentioned that because by default, this start number was the very first number in case of left and was the very last number in case of right. Okay. So in case of mid, you have to specify where you want to start extracting from. I want to start extracting from 1, 2, 3, 4. Fourth text, fourth letter, fourth character. Now, why is this fourth character? Because C is first, G is second, dash is third. Dash is also taken to be as a character. Even if you have spaces, the spaces are also taken as a character. Instead of dash, if I would have had a space, that space would also have counted as a character place. Okay. So now my starting will be 4. my starting will be 4. How many number of characters you want to extract? Now, this is what we mentioned in left and right. How many numbers you want to extract? I want to extract one only, which is L. How many number of characters you want to extract? I want to extract just one character, which is L. So I give 1. I want to start from the 4th place. 1, 2, 3, 4. C, G, dash, L. So 4th. And how many characters you want to extract? Just one character. And see, I get the answer as L. I get the answer as L. If I would have had a space over here, see, I've deleted that dash and I've kept a space, still I get the same answer, which means that this space is being read as a character. If I would have mentioned 3 over here, then I would have got just a blank. Just a blank. See, just a blank. So, a space is also read as a character. Correct? Now moving on, suppose I have the category, I have the number, I have the type of the customer. From this, I want to take out the customer ID. I want to make the customer ID basically. Suppose one department, my entire company, one department has given me the character category, one department has given me number, and one department has given me the type of the customer. Now I want to combine these to form a single customer ID. I use a AND operator. Basically, concatenate operator, where you concatenate different characters together to form a string. We are not breaking it, we are concatenating it. Here we were extracting. We were not breaking anything. We were extracting something. We were extracting a text from a string. Here I will be combining all of these, concatenating all of these to get the customer ID. Suppose what do I do is that first thing is this particular cell, CG. This is the first character which I want. Then I want a dash. Now how do I get a dash? You can't simply write a dash over here. A dash over here will mean a minus sign. So how can you just simply subtract two things? So what do? I use a AND operator. So I will write AND. Then when you mention any character, you have to mention it within the quotes. So within the quotes, I will mention the minus. So CG dash. For a dash, I had to do all of these. AND or the ampersand. Basically, we call this as ampersand operator. And then dash within the quotations. Otherwise, this dash will be read as a minus. So anything you write along with the concatenate, you have to write it within the quotes. Just that when you select a cell, you do not have to put this within the quotes, because Excel will read it as a text only. Okay. Then you give again an AND operator, because along with this, I have the next thing as type. Again, you want a dash. So again, an AND operator, open the quotes, dash, and again, close the quotes. Again, we have the number. So again, an ampersand, concatenate, and then a number. So first CG, for the dash, you had to use the concatenate. Concatenating dash within the quotes, along with, again, concatenating type. Along with that, concatenating dash within the quotes, concatenating with the number. So this is how you frame the entire thing. Is it clear now? Okay. See, I will get the entire same thing. This is the beauty of Excel. how you can manipulate different types of things. And as a text function contains a lot of functions, at this level, this is what you will have to learn. This, all of these are not very easy to understand. You have to study it again and again just to understand and get the concept clear. Next, we have something as trim function. Now, what is a trim function? This trim function trims all the spaces which is on the left and which is on the right of the letters. Suppose I keep a letter, I keep something as here, I have given space. See, I have given space. I'm writing something, cat maybe, giving space. So I've given multiple spaces before and multiple spaces after. I want to remove these spaces. So I use a trim function. And see, it removes all the spaces. See, it removes all the spaces, even after and before. If I had two words, cat and maybe space, kitten. Okay. So see what it did? It removed all the spaces which were before cat. It will not remove the spaces which are between the words. It will not remove the spaces which are between the words, but it will remove the spaces which is at the starting and which is at the end. But if I give more than one space, still, see, it removed those extra spaces and it just kept one space. So again, how does a trim function works? It removes all the spaces from the start. It removes all the spaces from the end. It removes multiple spaces between the two words, just leaving one space. So it left just one space over here. All other spaces before and after were removed. So zero spaces here, just one space in between two words. This is what is my answer using the trim function. Okay, this is used when we are dealing with a lot of data and the data is not clear or not in a good form, unclean data basically. So in the process of cleaning the data, we do this. Next, the last function of the text category over here is the find function. Suppose I want to find something, maybe I want to find this category CG. Maybe I want to find this category CG or maybe I want to find this mid in from this entire string. So I use the find function. The very first thing is, what is you want to find? What is the thing? What is the text which you want to find? I want to find CG. From where do you want to find the CG? From this text. And what should be the starting place of finding? Will it be starting from 1? Will it be starting from 2, 3, where? So here in this case, I want to start from the very first. I will just leave this as blank because as you can see, anything which is there in the brackets, is not a compulsory argument. So it is not necessary to specify that argument. So you get a 1 over here. So CG is found at the first place. Now, suppose I had more than, maybe I had CG twice. Suppose here I had again a CG. Again a CG is there. It will take the very first time it will find the CG. And that is why we have the start num. I wanted to find the last CG. So what do I do? I will keep my start num as maybe 3. as maybe 3. So it will start searching. Basically, the start num is the place where it will start searching from. So it will start searching from the third character. It will start searching from this dash. If nothing is specified, it will start searching from the very first. It will start searching from the very first. Clear? It will start searching from the very first. So I will keep this as maybe 3. So it starts searching from this dash. I want to ignore the first CG and I want to take out the last CG which is there. And see, I get a 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. These are 10, 11 and 12. So it started, basically, it got 12 number from the C. So it will give you the first letter, it will give you the first number where it started from. So it started from the 12th number in this entire list. Again, I'll repeat. What is the text which you want to find? I want to find CG. From where do you want to find CG? This entire thing. This entire thing. From where do you want to start searching from? The third character. The third character. So it searched after the third character. It will ignore everything which is before the third character. If nothing is specified, then it will take it as 1. It will start searching from the very first place itself. Is it clear? Is it clear to all of you? Is it clear to all of you? I will drag this down. I will keep here a 3 so that you all understand that why it is taken as 12. Why it is taken as 12. Why it is taken as 12.